two-thirds of members were present, I declare the motion negatived.
Second motion. Honorable Wong Kwok-kin's motion to relieve Dr. Honorable Shu Ka-chun of his duties as a member of the Legislative Council. Members who wish to speak, please press the request to speak button. I call upon Mr. Wong Kwok-kin to speak and move the motion. President, I'm moving the motion according to ROP 49B1. To relieve Mr. Shu Ka-chun of his duties as a member of the Legislative Council, I must declare here that I have no grudges with Mr. Shu Ka-chun, and I'm not targeting Mr. Shu Ka-chun himself, but the matter itself in order to uphold justice. The rationale for moving this motion is accordance to Basic Law 79(6). President, according to Article 79(6), if a member is convicted and sentenced to imprisonment for 1 month or more for a criminal offence committed within or outside the region and is relieved of his or her duties by a motion passed by two-thirds of the members of the Legislative Council present, then he or she will lose her membership of this council. As I said in my motion in 2019, on the 24th of April, Mr. Shiu was convicted of incitement to commit public nuisance and also incitement to incite public nuisance. He was sentenced to 8 months imprisonment for each offense. Since the sentence is in line with the requirement in the Basic Law and also the ROP, I am therefore moving the motion according to the law, and I am implementing my duty under the law in order to trigger the process. I am triggering the relevant procedure for two reasons. One, the provision to disqualify a member is in the Basic Law, ROP, and also the Legislative Council Ordinance. This is written in our law. It is in black and white. Hong Kong is a society with the rule of law. If a member has contravened the relevant provisions, and if the court has already ruled on it, no matter what the reasons are, what the defense is, we must trigger the process. This is a way to respect the law and also to give play to the rule of law. Secondly, the provisions stipulate that this should not be targeted against a certain member, but actually, it is a requirement to keep all legislators on their toes. In the past, there have been members who were disqualified because they were sent to prison. Mr. Wong Kwok-kin, your mobile phone. Therefore, we must maintain the fairness and consistency of the law. We should do what we did in the past and deal with Mr. Shu Ka-chun in the same way. Otherwise, it is unfair to other members who were disqualified in the past. And this would also impact on the credibility of the council. I will now specifically speak on these two justifications. President, whether it is China or the Western world, we respect the law and think that we should abide by the law. Chinese philosophers said that before the law, everybody is equal. And Aristotle, the Greek philosopher, said in the book Politics, said that the law is order. We should have good laws before we can have good order. He pointed out that the law is an important way to maintain social order. Therefore, if everyone ignores the law in a certain place, they do not follow the law, then there will be chaos. Hong Kong has always placed emphasis on the rule of law. We respect the legal system. Even if there is dissatisfaction, it is expressed in a peaceful and orderly manner. However, since the illegal Occupy movement in 2014, our concept of following the law has been distorted. They said they would break the law in order to seek justice, and they talked about so-called civil disobedience. That was an excuse of breaking the law. As long as you put forward an ideal, a lofty ideal, using specious arguments, then you can put the rule of law aside so that youngsters would find it all right to break the law. And they have no regard for the criminal liability they have to face. Therefore, in 2014, people stormed the government headquarters. They blocked the roads. They did not allow traffic to pass through. And then in 2016, there was the Mong Kok riot. There was arson, the throwing of bricks. And then in June this year, and until now, we have this large-scale riot. Rioters felt that they would not have to be responsible for breaking the law, so they were beating up people, they were vandalizing places and throwing petrol bombs. The rule of law has been hurt and Hong Kong society is deteriorating. The source of all this is those who said that as long as you had lofty ideals, it was all right to break the law, and that could be traced to the 2014 illegal Occupy movement. In the judgment, the court quoted from the concept of justice to explain what is meant by civil disobedience. One of the elements is that you must do it in a peaceful and non-violent way. And secondly, protesters must expect punishment. And through receiving punishment, they can then exemplify the injustice of the law. But let us look at the Occupy movement. How many were willing to accept criminal sanction? Many of them knew they were breaking the law, but they did not want to be arrested. This is a problem of breaking the law but not having been arrested and not having been sentenced. And that is why young people today think that they are helping Hong Kong, but they go for violence and vandalism, and they don't want to take responsibility for it. When they are arrested, they use every means to escape, and some people were trying to snatch them away from the hands of the police. So law enforcers were attacked. If we say this is a continuation of the illegal Occupy movement, I think it is because there was incitement for the public to break the law and escape from criminal liability. The situation is deteriorating. The court was quoting from John Rawls' A Theory of Justice. Mr. Shu Ka-chun was one of the 10 who vouched their pledge to the Occupy movement. On different occasions and in different interviews, Mr. Shiu expressly said that he would take responsibility and commitment for his own acts. He also said that even if he would be imprisoned because of this, he would still do it. He emphasized many times that he would not run away from criminal sanction. So since the court had already convicted him, and he was given a sentence of over a month, the Legislative Council should act according to the law to relieve him of his duties. This is legitimate, correct, and right. In 2014, Mr. Shu Ka-chun took part in the Occupy movement, and he should understand the consequences. Like when he took part in the election of LegCo, he should know that if he was convicted and sentenced, he would lose his qualification as a member. So he should have been prepared that he would be penalized by disqualification by the council. As the judge said, the second element of civil disobedience was such that the importance of civil obedience is such that those people would have to be penalized, including all legal sanctions. Therefore, Mr. Shiu should not object to this motion. Neither should any member in the chamber. As a member of the legislature, if we don't follow the laws we ourselves make, then the dignity of the entire council would be trashed. We would be laughed at. Moreover, if you break the law and you shy away from legal responsibility and you spread this message, then the public will also act irresponsibly and they would run away from legal liability. This is the biggest problem in Hong Kong nowadays. It all boils down to the opening of the Pandora box by the pandems, and that is that you can break the law to seek justice. I'd just like to ask a simple question. The 10 diehard people in the Occupy movement, only Mr. Shiu faced criminal liability. Where have the other 9 gone? No one knows. But so-called civil disobedience has just deteriorated into illegal acts without people wanting to shoulder liability. President, the other point is fairness. If we have these laws, and indeed someone was relieved of his duty under these provisions, then we should be consistent. We should not condone such acts. I believe some people would criticize my motion as political persecution, that it is a useless motion. I believe these accusations would be hollow in the face of the facts. In fact, before reunification, members were disqualified because they were sentenced, like in 1993. Mr. Leung Kam Ho was convicted of bribing and providing an advantage. He was immediately disqualified. He was the first one. And then in 1998, Mr. Chin Pui Chung was sentenced to 3 years in prison because of using forged documents. He was also disqualified. We can see then that no matter what the offenses are and no matter what the motives of committing offenses are, as long as the sentence reaches the threshold in the basic law, the relevant member should be relieved of his duty. There should not be any exceptions. I cannot see why Mr. Shiu can be exempted. If the motion is not carried, it will set a very bad precedent. It is also unfair to other members who were disqualified because they were imprisoned. Mr. President, violence, vandalism, injuring other people and arson, these seem to have become commonplace in Hong Kong. But if you really want to do good to Hong Kong, you should not pull Hong Kong down. You should not say, let us go for mutual destruction, and then you run away when you break the law. This is a cowardly act. I move the motion now to relieve Mr. Shiu Ka-chun of his duties as a member of the LegCo. But I respect Mr. Shiu for his commitment and his facing legal sanction. Frankly, since June, amongst the people who were arrested, how many turned themselves in? How many vandalized facilities and came out to say they would take up responsibility? To those who break the law and run away from legal liability, society should condemn them. Law enforcers should enforce the law, arrest the people, and convict them. As to those who incite people to commit the law and use different excuses to condone the rioters, we should find them out. They are inciting other people to break the law for their own political end. President, no matter how much grievances the public and young people have, how dissatisfied they are with the government, we cannot justify violence and allow it to become regular. Therefore, at this time, I will act according to the law and rebuild the spirit of the rule of law. I hope members will start from the angle of fairness and the rule of law and support the motion. I so submit. Members, I Now propose the question to you that Mr. Wong's Kwok-kin's motion be passed.
Mr. Tony Chair, President, previously when I spoke on the motion to relieve Ms. Tanya Chan's duties as the LegCo members, I talked about the justification under the basic law and the factors that I considered. And this case involving Mr. Shiu Ka-chun is the same. He is involved in the incitement charges in respect of the Occupy Central movement. He was convicted of two charges, incitement to commit public nuisance and incitement to incite public nuisance. He was convicted on both counts and both and he was sentenced to 8 months for both. And to be served concurrently, and the relevant imprisonment term exceeds the threshold in the basic law, and and there's no procedural impropriety involved. Therefore, I support the motion. I support the president in relieving Mr. Shiu Ka-chun's duty as a LegCo member according to the rules. And I would like to say something more about the involvement of Mr. Tanya Chan and Mr. Shiu Ka-chun. The judgment is as long as 268 pages, in which there are many important legal concepts elaborated, and also the illegal nature and adverse damage of the movement. The opposition usually talk about usually with chant slogans such as civil disobedience is not guilty, but actually the court has said that civil disobedience is not a defense to any offense. The court will not assess whether there is civil disobedience behind the offense. This can only be considered as a mitigating factor for sentencing. And also in that occupation movement, the nuisance and inconvenience caused was disproportionate, and therefore the court will not consider such acts of offense. And in the recent extradition bill protests, serious violence was committed, there was arson, people were harmed with by weapons and such as knives, and even remote bombs were used. And there were road blockages causing disproportionate inconvenience. And if they have read, these people have read the judgments, they will not call this a civil disobedience, and they will not call these rioters in black righteous fighters. And also in civil disobedience, the activists would accept punishment. And they said that the nine in the Occupy Central movement would turn themselves in and admit and shoulder the responsibility. But in that case, the nine accused hire lawyers, and they also put up a defense, and they resorted to various means to try to delay the trial, and it gave the people the impression that they did not want to shoulder the criminal responsibility. And now many young students took part in the current riots. They wouldn't like to shoulder the criminal liability. That's why they wear masks. And when people took photos, they would beat them up. It was all done in an attempt to evade responsibility. As I've said, if we did not have the Occupy Central movement, we wouldn't have the current anti-extradition bill, protests and violence. Mr. Shiu Ka-chun took the lead in stirring up the violence, and they have spread the wrong message of that if you break the law for a just cause, you are not guilty. So we should relieve Mr. Shiu of his duty as a LegCo member. I support the motion.
Does another member wish to speak? President, Dr. Junius Ho. Thank you, President. Again, with a heavy heart, I would like to speak on the motion. First, I support Mr. Wong Kwok-kin's motion. Just now, Mr. Wong Teng Kwong moved to relieve Ms. Tania Chen of her duties as a member of the Legislative Council. Both Ms. Tania Chen and Mr. Shiu Ka-chun were convicted of similar offenses. The difference is one had already paid his price. While I hold different political views from Mr. Shiu Ka-chun, I respected his integrity. He swore to pledge allegiance to the Basic Law, and therefore while I speak in support of Mr. Wong Kwok-kin's motion to relieve Mr. Shiu Ka-chun of his duties, I hold some respect for him because he's willing to face the consequence of his behavior. So no matter what you do, you should be willing to show the responsibility. While I find Mr. Shiu's conduct regrettable, I commend him on in this regard. Still, under Article 79.6 of the Basic Law, when a member is convicted and sentenced to imprisonment for 1 month or more for criminal offence committed within or outside the region and is relieved of his duties by a motion passed by two-thirds of the members of the Legislative Council present, the article itself is very straightforward, and there is no need for a lengthy debate. Even for your party members who or members of your camp who can speak very eloquently, it would be difficult for them to speak for you, although they would only care for their positions, they do not care for reason. So if we can have both, I think we should stand with justice, we should stand on the side of justice. So in the motion related to Ms. Tania Chen, 24 votes supported Ms. Tania Chen. So I believe there will be the same number of votes in support of Mr. Shiu Ka-chun in this motion. But most regrettably, I have to condemn the pro-establishment camp for lack of solidarity. They have no concern for something that doesn't concern them. It is indeed a big irony. I really want to give them a reminder. Of course, Mr. Ray Chen is laughing out loud. I think, yes, I can fully understand why Mr. Ray Chen is so happy. In the community, many people have asked, how come the pro-establishment camp has behaved in this manner. We have two motions to deal with two members from the opposition camp, and yet only 29 of us are present. This is hard to understand. Is it because of a lack of communication? You win this time because you would only defend your own camp. You have no concern for the rule of law. And I think I risk a lot in saying so because I need my members from my own camp to support me in a motion to reprimand me. I may face the risk of being disqualified. Now, no one can remain in a certain position forever. If you cannot do your duty when you're in a certain position, it's pointless for you to stay there forever. It doesn't matter how long you stay in a position, and the number of pages you read doesn't matter. Whether juniors who will be disqualified is just a minor matter. The point is whether we will defend to the very end for the sake of truth. So we will never cling on to our seat. We will never feel frustrated or feel devastated simply because we've lost a position. We won't feel that we have lost our means of livelihood. So long as you have the will, you can still do what you intend to do. I really respect Mr. Shu Ka-chun. At least he has the guts to, he has spine. He upheld his undertaking. Even though you are from the opposition camp, I will take my hat off to you because you have spine. Well, but that doesn't mean that I will always stand with anyone from my camp, even though he has done something wrong. This is the real attitude to serve the people. Why am I an independent? Because to serve the people, I don't care what camp you are from, so long as you have done your best. This is what is to be expected of a legislator. This is our integrity. It's okay, we have heated exchanges here. I do appreciate members from the opposition camp. They always say that it's okay. After debate, we have no grudges. Yes, I really appreciate that. Now, I will fight to the very end in this chamber. I would hold on to my position. But even when we meet outside the chamber, in the elevator, I can say hi or good morning to you. It doesn't matter whether you are from the Civic Party or the Liberal Party or the Democratic Party or the DAB. It doesn't mean that I will support you simply because you're from a certain party. Only by so doing can we have real progress and can we really serve the 7 million population in Hong Kong. But if we always have to be so polarized, and if we forget who are our real masters, this is regrettable. I support Mr. Wong Kwok-kin's motion, not because I hate Mr. Shiu. Well, I will pray for Donald Trump even though I don't agree with him. So I have no hatred in my life. I hope you can do better. However, I respect Mr. Shiu because he has honored his duties. Now, as a statesman, I won't call him a politician, at least Mr. Shiu has spine, he displayed nobleness, and I hope that come the 1st of January, now we have so many new and young district councillors, although some of them may be charged with unlawful assembly. Now, I hope that they can genuinely serve the community. We might have lost our positions, we will not lose the spirit to serve the people. Now, if they don't have the spirit to serve the community, it would be a waste of, we would let down the public's expectations, even if they have obtained the DC seats. Now, I'm not trying to digress. We should not be zombies. In the past 6 months, people have wreaked havoc to Hong Kong. And if we can be cold-blooded enough to slap fear, I think I don't know what to say about this, because we may face the same fate in the future. And why don't we do a proper job? The Civic Party and the Democratic Party had a landslide victory. Their spokesman, Mr. Wu Chi-wai, did not display any pleasure. He didn't say that because of their proper tactics, they got over 90% of the seats. In fact, he said that the pro-establishment camp did a lot of support. What is your point of order? I'm of the view that Junius Ho has digressed seriously. Well, I was about to say so when you got up. Well, I have put up with that for a long time. So have I. Mr. Junius Ho, thank you. I might have digressed for a minute or so out of my 11-minute speech. Dr. Helena Wong likes to just hear the surface meaning of our remarks. In fact, the motion is very straightforward. There is no need for us to be pretentious. Now, you and I have pledged to uphold the basic law, and we must honor that pledge, not just paying lip service to it. We must really stick to the spirit of our oath. I really hope that maybe that is to ask too much of you, but I hope that if you have this proper understanding and if you really uphold the basic law in discharging your duties as a legislator, you should at most abstain from voting and not vote against the motion. The meeting is suspended until 5:15 p.m.